Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Seahawks going up against the Eagles.
Larry, we have played 266 games in this NFL season. Only one remains, and it's the biggest of them all. EA Sports is proud to present coverage of the Super Bowl. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. Well over 100 million people watching around the world. Welcome to you all. Super Bowl 52 underway from Minneapolis. Paul Turner now to return. And a good effort on a return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Fake here on first down. Steps away. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on this first drive. Instead, second down. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line. Hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Throwing now is Wentz. And he rips that one incomplete there. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. And that'll make it third down. And a look at Seattle's defense.
Earl Thomas has the speed, quickness, and skills to be a cornerback in the NFL. I think he would have been a good one. But playing in the middle of this field as a free safety, I think he's the best eraser in the NFL. Takes care of any mistakes that happen in front of him. And hardly ever lets anything get over his head.
Wins. And Jeffrey's got it. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. An Eagle first down. Wins hooking up with Jeffrey. Alshon Jeffrey so dangerous, even when a defender's near him.
He's got such a big body. Ability to run, positions himself well, excellent control. And you're exactly right. Even if people are draped on him, he often comes up with the catch. He really symbolizes what people are looking for in receivers in today's NFL.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. And he's already got two catches on the opening drive. I know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on. I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through. Pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he probably trailed on that headset right now.
Yeah! Take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown.
Eagles.
With the first touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. And on the grandest of stages, with the whole world watching the Super Bowl, they come out and get the first points.
You feel about Brandon, but for me, watching the beginning of the Super Bowl, I often wondered how come it's not just a fumble fest? How come the ball's not all over the place? The nerves, the interim in between of the 2 weeks waiting for the game, but this team came out and handled it just like it was a regular season walk in the park. Terrific start.
He's got it, and the Eagles lead at 7-0. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it ends in a touchdown run by LeGarrette Blount. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Check, check, who's caring for Thomas Rawls. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it will be second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running now as they run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through.
So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. But they face a second and long to start things out. From the gun, it's Wilson. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And a loose football. Ross loses it. And it's picked up by the Eagles. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
The Eagles offense back out onto the field. It's a quick turnaround for them after the turnover, but the way they moved it on their last drive, they're probably eager to get right back at it.
And you know me and you know my tendencies in this situation. What do I want right now?
Be aggressive.
Be aggressive. Take your shot right here.
He's going to take a shot for the end. This has caught. Yeah. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Alshon Jeffrey, 23 yards from a touchdown. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead. Well, that didn't take long. The turnover instantly almost turning into points.
And when that happens, a lot of teams have the mentality of let's strike right now. You got them off balance after the turnover or the takeaway. Let's go get it. And that's exactly what they did.
Now Sturgis on to add the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. A nice, tidy little drive there, getting the ball in excellent field position, and only one play to score it. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. Tyler Lockett now with a return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And a lot of teams quick plays. We know that, right?
Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Nigel Brown coming in from that outside linebacker spot to bury him for a loss of 7.
And that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football. Late to a sack. That's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around. Don't you try to cover in the secondary.
Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And they'll get him down here at the 23. Give him 3 on the play. And that'll force upon him a 3rd and 14. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
On 3rd down, both sides. And this will go to the 28-yard line. Calling a gain of 4, but not enough. The punt team going to need to be summoned here on 4th down. Now John Ryan, 12th year in the league, on to punt it away. Back deep is Darren Sproles. And this is taken at the 23. Once more the juke. Nice footwork at the 25. And all the way down inside the 25 before he gets out of bounds. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they locked it really well.
Open now to get back in the end zone on this fourth possession. And nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete. Back to the air on second down. Wentz gets by him and now a little daylight. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Give him seven there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
And he connects words. Gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. An Eagle first down wins to Ertz.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to.
And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, add that play to his resume real, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
So we've reached halftime in a low-scoring 51st Super Bowl from Houston. As we'll send you down to Orlando.
Can you seriously just skip the halftime of the Super Bowl?
Who does that? It's a Super Bowl. Watch a halftime show. Here we go. Third quarter action now. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. On the return of the All-Pro 2 years ago, Tyler Lockett. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten the first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden, it looms big. It gets harder and harder to obtain that first down.
And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
No gain on the play there. Second down.
While there is no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. And we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window. They've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. They got 29 yards that time.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted, out of Stanford, and plays like a number one receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great. He's the one that typically comes up with the football.
Absolutely. His roots go all the way back to Gulf Breeze, Florida, where he's from, right on the water near Pensacola. And then, of course, to Stanford. And boy, he's been good. On second down, Rawls. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. Calling a loss of 2 on the play. And they're going to face a third down.
And that's another stop for the defense, something we've seen all game long. They've been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
This is caught. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a gain of 6 as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Seahawks with possession of the football, but they do trail here to begin quarter number 4. They come out here in the eye. There's Wilson. That's caught at the 1. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
What a game this defense has played. They're pitching a shutout, so it'll be fun to watch down the stretch to see if their defensive coordinator continues to be as aggressive as he's been all game long.
Rolls, and he will take this one in for a Seattle touchdown. Thomas Rolls taking it in, and the Seahawks have made this a one-score game.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5-play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right, and if you have that 1-5-play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. Wentz now on first down. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got to lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking a chance of putting it out there. A little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this. Fourth quarter, as you said, trying to claim that advantage.
Yeah, that would probably should be picked up.
Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And he's brought down after a good game. A really nice gain of 25 yards. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. And they'll go Wentz to bunt here. Room here to run. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. They'll run again with Blunt. Fighting him off. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. They'll run him now out of the gun. A little juke. Brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Oh, look at this. Wentz going to throw. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Now a carry for Blunt. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and three now.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity, usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you come up and take it back.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. The gain of 5 that time gives him the conversion and makes it first and goal. And this defense, they needed that one more stop to have any chance, but that completion, that's likely going to seal their fate.
And you can hear it in your voice, that one more stop.
Feel their pain.
Oh, it was so important. They just didn't get it done. Wow, what a way to finish this one off.
Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. This offense on third down today, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and goal. Wentz with a kneel down, and that will be the final act of this game. And the Lombardi Trophy will rest in the city of brotherly love. The Philadelphia Eagles are the Super Bowl champs. For the victors getting to hoist that Lombardi Trophy, you know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.
Super Bowl champs, the Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.